Hello everyone, how are you? How was your week? Good, bad, and I don't know. Well, you should remember the summer vacation is coming soon, so I need you to hold on tight. Hang in there so you can enjoy all the free time you can have. And also, I know in June, some of the fifth graders are graduating too. I know you are excited, but I need you to finish it strong. Amen? Amen. Okay, now let's give a spirit five together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Spirit five! Good job. Everyone, please stand up. We're going to start with the call to worship and opening prayer. And have I close your eyes and hear me out. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord tell their story. Those who redeem from the hand of the foe, those who gather from the lands, from east and west, from north and south. Coming from Psalm 107, verse 1, 2, 3. Let me pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we want to give thanks to You for giving us this day, the day where we can continue to worship You together physically and spiritually. This month is quite special for many of us, because after this month, we are going to go to the next grade. So this month will be the month where we can finish all the work at school and moving forward. But in the midst of all those things, let us continue to remind ourselves about You, that You are the one who gave us this blessing, and You are the one who gave us the love. So let us continue to worship You with all of the things we have. And as we do that, let us receive the blessings from You as we always do so. Let us experience the salvation which You gave it to us, so we can glorify Your name and honor Your name. And also we pray for those who don't know You. If there are people who is with us, but don't really know who You are, give them the Holy Spirit so they can understand Your love. We thank You and love You. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. Thank you everybody. And now we are going to sing Jesus, We Enthrone You together. Let's sing.
Jesus, we enthrone You. We proclaim You our King. Standing here in the midst of us, we raise You up with our praise. And as we worship the throne, and as we worship the throne, and as we worship the throne, come Lord Jesus and take Your place. Jesus, we enthrone You. We proclaim You our King. Standing here in the midst of us, we raise You up with our praise. And as we worship in the throne, and as we come Lord Jesus and take Your place.
Good job. And now we are going to confess our sin. Everybody close your eyes and hear me out. Jesus Christ bore our sin in His body on the cross, so that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. By His wounds we have been healed. So let us know our failure and disobedience and come back to the Lord with faith. This is our time to remember who Jesus is. Jesus, the Son of God, came to this world as a 100% human being, 100% God. He died on the cross and resurrected on the third day. And whomever believes in him, through faith alone, yesterday, today, and tomorrow, sins are forgiven. If there are anything you did against God, bring it before him and ask him for the forgiveness. And let us pray. Father, Lord, again, we thank you for everything that you have done for us, Lord. Thank you so much for all the things you have done. Now, as we are the sinners, Lord, we have come before you and asking you for the forgiveness. As we do that, Lord, we know that you have forgiven yesterday, today, and tomorrow's sin. And with the faith, Lord, we want to continue to glorify your name and honor your name and do this worship so that you could, you know, remember us and you could continue to, you know, use us in your name and in your kingdom. Lord, be with us. Let us truly have a pure heart before you. We thank you. Father, thank you again for giving us the time to repent before you. We know that this is very important time for all of us because it is the time that we get to remind ourselves who we were and who we became after believing in Jesus. We were nobody, sinners, and who are dead before believing in Jesus Christ. But after believing in you, who died and resurrected for us, believing that you are our Lord and our Savior, we became your sons and daughters. Therefore, we who became righteous through Jesus can now worship you and be with you. So as we worship at this time, let us glorify your name. Let us only focus on you, who is the beginning and the end, and who is the King of Kings. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. And now we are going to recite the assurance of forgiveness on three. One, two, three. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John chapter 1, verse 9. Thank you very much. And now is the praise time, everyone. Let's dance and sing. Cue!
Everlasting arms, and where would I be? music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, have is yours, every single breath. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart, yeah. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus.
All about you. Excellent job. And now we are going to recite Apostles' Creed together. If you memorized it, I want you to close your eyes and recite it with one voice. If you didn't, I have it on the screen, so I want you to read it out loud with one voice. On three, ready? One, two, three. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Thank you, everybody. Everybody get your Bible, and we are going to read it from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 1. All right, Pastor Joon is going to read it out loud for you. All right. Better a dry crust with peace and quiet than a house full of feasting with strife. Amen. And it was the God's word coming from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 1. And Pastor Joon is going to come up, and he is going to preach with the title, May His Peace Be With You. Hear him out. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Sunday worship. As you know, today is first week of June, and I am very excited today. Why? Because I get to meet some new friends who register for June worship. I praise God for giving us this opportunity. In the same time, I pray that God will destroy this COVID so that we can have normal meeting at church soon. Now, again, let me tell you, if you couldn't register for June worship, that is okay. The registration for July in-person worship is coming very soon. So make sure to register as soon as possible. Amen? Anyways, let's start, everyone. As you guys know, this month too, we are going to focus on the book of Proverbs, which is the wisdom books of Hebrew scripture. So before Pastor Joon continues his sermon, let me ask you, do you remember what I shared last month? Yes. Last month, I shared to you the requirements of gaining the true wisdom from God. So how many requirements did I share? Yes, 4. Humility, purity, faithfulness, and maturity. By going over these 4 requirements, I inform you that you can establish the relationship with God and gain the wisdom from God. Amen. Amen. Well, now that I reminded you about what we learned last month, what I'm going to do in this month is look at some of the God's wisdom. I know we're not going to look at everything in the short period of time, but I still want us to look at a few of God's wisdom. To do that, I need you to be humble, pure, faithful, and mature, so you can understand it with your heart. Amen. Amen. Also, if you have time, I want you to spend time to read the Proverbs on your own and find the wisdom of God. All right. Today we were able to read from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 1. What does it say? Better a dry crust with peace and quiet than a house full of feasting with strife. I think we need some translator to understand what this is saying, because I know some of you might not understand what this says. Well, what passage is trying to say is this. Better a dry crust. This is referring to eating dry crust bread, like the bread that is put outside too long so it became dry. And the passage is telling us that it is better to eat dry bread in peace and quiet than what? The opposite, which is a house full of feasting, meaning a house full of many foods, but with strife that is full of bitter and anger and fighting. Now, what do you think? Would you agree to the passage? Would you rather eat dry bread in a peace and quiet environment than eat many food in a place where there is a full of bitterness, anger, and fight? Yes, some of you might say, I don't care about all the trouble. So I'm ready to eat good food than a piece of dry bread. And some other might say, I don't want to eat food under trouble or pressure. I like peace and quiet. Many of you can have different opinions, but we must understand that the passage is very clear. Today's passage did not say, well, we have 2 options. You can choose either or. When you look at the beginning of the passage, it says, better. It is better to eat dry bread. This means that God is teaching us to choose dry bread over the feast, where you can enjoy peace and quietness. Now, the food in the passage does not mean that from now on, you need to eat a dry bread only and every day. I know many of us like many foods, It will be sad if we are told to eat only one food, that is, a dry bread. But what we have to know from today's passage is this. The food, dry bread, is not the food that we think. Huh? Yes! After meditating, Pastor Joon believes that the dry bread is referring to Jesus Christ. According to the Bible, in John chapter 6, verse 35, it said, "Then Jesus declared, 'I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty.'" Amen. What the passage is truly saying is that it is important to have Jesus Christ, who provides peace and quiet. What peace, Pastor Joon? The world peace? Well, that is good, but in this case, it is talking about the inner peace. With Jesus, we can have inner peace. We can worry no more because He will take care of everything for us. But many of us forget about this truth. Because of all the things we have in our life, our eyes are blinded with the feast many times. The world says it is good for you. It is worth it to have troubles, bitterness, anger, and fight, as long as you can enjoy the good things in this world. It is the temptations which many people will go through. But again, by looking into today's passage, we must understand that the believers of Jesus Christ should choose the dry bread that is with peace and quiet, because that is where God wants us to be. This world will pass away, but we know Jesus won't. We also know that Jesus is the one who gave His life in a place of ours. Choosing His love and peace is something much more worthy than what this world can give. So everyone, even though we went over one verse, I think we learned so many things. And now that we know the meaning behind the passage, let me ask you, would you choose dry bread with peace, or would you choose feast with strife? I hope you can make the right choice. And I hope you are able to listen with humble, pure, faithful, and mature. Amen. Amen. Let me pray. Father, Lord, again, we thank you for the message you have given us, Lord. From today's passage, Proverbs chapter 17, verse 1, we learn that it is better to have a dry bread with peace and quiet. Lord, let us understand what that means. It means that we have to choose Jesus Christ, who is with peace and quiet. This world says loud is good. All this temptation is good. All this trouble is good. And it's worth it to get it. But Lord, let us understand, at the end, the most important thing is having you. That is the true wisdom that you are teaching from today's verse. We thank you for everything, especially your love, giving Jesus Christ and replacing our death. Lord, we thank you. And as we continue to walk with you, help us and guide us through as you always do so. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, everybody, it's the offering time. I want you to get the offering basket and the offering. I want you to collect the offerings from your families. The reason we are doing this is so that we could remind ourselves who God is. God, who created everything in this world, have given us everything to us. So as He provided every single thing, we are giving the partial thing back to Him with a thankfulness. So I want you to do that, and we are going to sing doxology together. Let's sing.
Two, three. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him, all
Thank you. And today we have Isaac teacher who is going to pray for an offering. So everybody close your eyes and let's pray.
Hi, Gospeland, let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for this day that you have given us and this time that you have given us to share your word through Pastor Joon. I pray that as we go into Bible study, I pray that we will all have open ears and open hearts to listen to what our teachers have to say. And I pray that after this Bible study, we'll have a great week and we will start anticipating a great summer and a great summer filled with you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Isaac teacher. And now we are going to recite Lord's Prayer. If you memorize it, I want you to close your eyes and recite it together with one voice. If you didn't, I have it on the screen, so I want you to read it out loud with Pastor Joon, okay? With one voice. On three, one, two, three. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Announcement time, everyone. Number one, BRC, the Bible Reading Challenge, is still going on. And this week, I have to tell you, we are finishing the Genesis. Yay! But everybody, if you are not doing the BRC, I really want you to try. And you still have the time to catch up, okay? And we're going into the second book of the Bible in Old Testament, which is the Exodus, very soon. And I'm very proud of you if you're continuing this on together with Pastor Joon, okay? And number two, breakout session is happening in online Zoom at 2 p.m. every Sunday. And I need you to remember, if you register for Joon Worship, you don't have to come into the Zoom breakout session because you're having a small group in the church. However, if you want to, it's an option that you may come in, okay? And number three, memory verse competition is happening in June 13 at 2:30 p.m. in Zoom. For this one, we have the registration went out to you and it's done now. Now, for those of you who registered, you have to come in at 2:30 so we could start our memory verse competition. And you have to memorize 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 8. All right, number four, we have fifth graders barbecue party. And I have to explain to you a little bit about this. There's a few changes here and there. Fifth graders graduation is going to happen in the same day where we're having the barbecue party. The graduation is going to be in our main worship room with our kindergarten and pre-K students. So all of you will be graduating in one place. And after we do graduation service, we're going to go out and have the barbecue with our families, okay? Now the date is June 19, and the time that you have to come to church is by 12 p.m. One more time, 12 p.m., not 12 a.m. I won't be there. I will be sleeping at home. So 12 p.m., I want you to come to the main worship room, not our worship room, where adults, your mommy and daddy is having a worship. All right, and I want you to remember that. Now there's a registration going out starting from today, so I need you to register the fifth graders, okay? Fifth graders, you have to register and your whole family to come. All right, and June worship has started today. And July worship registration will be out in next week or next week. So when it comes out, Pastor Joon will let you know and let you register as soon as possible. And now today's birthday. Ba-bum!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear my love, happy birthday to you. Good job everybody, I love you very much. It's time for us to go and say bye bye, but we have Zoom meetings. I hope we can meet you in Zoom, and I want you to be healthy, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.